Rev up your engines!
Future Sean says, Scotty, you see all the production issues on the Bronco? Yeah, it doesn't surprise me. You know, some of them are made in Mexico. Some of them are made in Michigan. It's a new design. They didn't build it before. Chip shortage, and that's going to make it harder for them to get all the parts. Don't buy a new vehicle. Wait a few years to see how they pan out. Because one, they're cheaper then if you want to buy a used one. And two, what if they got all kinds of problems? It's a lemon like the Ford Edsel, and then you're stuck with it. Don't buy any new design vehicle unless you got more money than sense. James Self says, Scotty, why is the Ford selling a Maverick for $20,000? Well, it's a compact pickup truck. Now, realize, they're all made in Mexico. Quality ain't gonna be all that great. And it's not a frame-on pickup truck. It's a unibody truck. It's the cheapest way you can possibly make them. You know, they come with those little baby engines, turbochargers, or four cylinders. I'm not a fan of that stuff. So they're gonna be making them as cheap as they possibly can. Maybe they'll hold up. Who knows? Model T Fords are cheap, and they sold a lot of them. But always be leery about something that's too cheap. Eduardo Gary says, I got a 2012 C250, 250,000 miles. Why is it still running? I have a code for a range selector problem, but the car runs fine. Why? Okay. Well, that's the range selector. That's the shifter. And then on the transmission, it says which gear it's in when you pull it down, the cable moves up and down. Who cares? Your car works. And really, you know, you got a Mercedes-Benz. As they age, they get all kinds of lights coming on them. I've had people look at used Mercedes. I said, you're nuts to buy one. You want, check it out for you. I check it out. And I sometimes find like 57 separate codes and they still run okay. So in a Mercedes, just ignore that crap. As long as it runs okay, it's got 250K, just keep doing whatever you've been doing. Drive it around. What the heck? You're playing with a house's money anyways. They rarely last that long anymore. Georgi Nakov says, what do you think of the Liquid Moly diesel purge? Is it safe to use it? Liquid Moly makes decent products, you know, and diesels do need cleaning. That's why, you know, they're not popular in the United States. Gasoline is very caustic. It's a good cleaner. We used to clean our ties with them years ago. It's a very good cleaner, but it's somewhat caustic. Diesel fuel is the opposite. It's slimy. It's not caustic at all. Bacteria and mold can actually grow in a diesel, so you do need to clean those things out every once in a while. It's not like gasoline. You never need to clean your car's gas tank if it's got gasoline, as long as you don't get water in it. Gasoline will kill anything in there, but diesel, no, it's a completely different story. John B says, Honda 1.5 turbo oil dilution. I've owned three so far, and all of them reek of gasoline, and the crankcase oil level is always way past full. Dealers, no help. What do you think? Well, one, I think you're not using your head. You own three of them. After the first one, I wouldn't have bought another two. Yeah, Honda's not talking about that stuff, you know. They're pretending it doesn't exist. Obviously, it does. Why would you make it up, you know? But you keep buying the cars. If the first one broke, I wouldn't buy a second one. I would have never bought the third one. What's that, you know? Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Fool me three times, I don't know what that's supposed to mean. V.L. Boltanski says, what do your opinion is of future plastic roads? Yeah, you know, they're still going to be making roads out of plastic bottles and stuff. No, what it is, it's just an additive to the asphalt. They're never going to make plastic roads. Plastic roads, my God, they'd melt. They'd start on fire. You know, delinquents would be putting gasoline and lighter fluid, lighting them up. They probably would skid. That's not going to happen anytime soon. Maybe in inside buildings or something for fancy things or in tunnels or something, but no. They do use the bottles, though, in some places. They recycle the bottles, plastic, and then they use it as an ingredient in the asphalt to keep it pliable. James Barger said, what'll happen if I don't replace the torn dust cover on my brake caliper? Well, you'll get more dust on your brakes. I've had cars that were so rusted out, they fell off. Never put them back on. They run perfectly fine. It doesn't do all that much. It's more a safety thing than anything else. So no rocks or anything get fallen and thrown in there, but I mean, it's not that something you're gonna think about anyways. Unless you drive off-road or something, and then, you know, plants get stuck in there and stuff, because it does shield plants from getting stuck in there too. So most guys just leave them off. They don't care. Doesn't do all that much. KVU says, what do you think of a 2001 Celica GTS of 220,000 miles? All right, I like the Celicas. That's a 2001. If it's got that Yamaha engine in it, I wouldn't buy it, because those engines always blow up. Every customer I had one of those were on their second or third engine. They just took potluck and bought used engines from a junkyard. The very interesting technology. They went fast when you revved them up high, but a lot of them blew up. They didn't hold up over time. So I would not buy one. If it had the regular Toyota engine, sure, go right ahead. Just don't overpay with that mileage. But if it's got the Yamaha engine, I wouldn't buy it. Poyngi Sanford said, what do you think of a Nissan Versa SL 2017? A rolling pile of junk. One of my daughter-in-laws had one. She said it was the worst car she ever had. It was an absolute pile of junk. They're so cheaply made. You know, I rented one time, and it was a pile of junk. We drove it 300-400 miles, and they rode like crap, rattly. The only thing good about it was it got good gas mileage. Now, rolling piles of junk, and if it's got an automatic transmission, it's got one of those crappy Jacko transmissions. Those things are rolling piles of junk. Pray Daily says, Scotty, what's the most reliable Jeep I can buy? A really old one that's been taken care of or rebuilt. In the 60s and 70s, they were well made. Then they got cheaper and cheaper and cheaper and cheaper. You'd be better to buy one that's been all done over and restored, or get one and restore it yourself, because the new ones are piles of junk and their resale values drop like a stone when they get old. The old ones, they were solid vehicles. Real solid vehicles. Now, if you want to go a little bit newer, you could try to find one when it says Daimler Chrysler, because a lot of the Daimler Chrysler Jeeps had the German transmissions, the German automatic transmissions, ZF, it's a German company, and those are excellent transmissions, so those were actually pretty good. Blake Jones says, what's your opinion on a 2013 Dodge Dart 1.4 turbo with 6-speed tranny? I rented one of those ones. They zip around. They don't ride all that well, but it had nothing to do with the muscle car Dodge Dart. You know, that's all Fiat technology and those things. Man, when those trannies break, you might as well junk the car. They don't make the darts anymore. They were a massive failure. They're kind of a stopgap. They didn't know what to do, so they said, oh, let's get rid of this model and make a Dodge Dart out of Italian car parts, you know. They're piles of junk as they age. I mean, they're fast and zippy. You want to drive around. What the heck? Hopefully you didn't pay much for it. Have a little cheap toy. That's okay, but it's like a Toyota Corolla or Honda Civic. You keep driving, it's going to fall apart at some point in time, and probably sooner than later. Jerome says, how can I find a mechanic like you? You can't. I'm the only one on the planet. There are good mechanics out there. You know, ask your friends, relatives. I got a whole video how to find a good mechanic. It's harder to find, though, because overheads are getting higher and higher and higher and higher, and they got to pay for their overheads. Take a dealership, even if they have good mechanics there. Some of those dealerships have $3 million a year overhead. They got to make $3 million bucks off of you clowns going there before they even make a profit. So you want to find a regular guy with a regular shop, not in a fancy part of town. They're out there. They're out there, but it's hard to find. And there aren't too many like me anymore, because the old school guys, we cared. A lot of the young guys, they might be okay, but most of them, they don't care. Mining Pro says, should I buy a Ram 2500 or GMC 2500? Which is better and will last? Well, I would say a GMC 2500. The 1500s are garbage, but the 2500s, hey, my AC guy Owen, he's got two of them now, and he loves them, because he'll do like the heating and air conditioning of an entire subdivision that they're building. So he's got to have big equipment and a truck that can be four-wheel drive and cannot get stuck because they're building houses and there's mud everywhere, right? They don't put the heating and air conditioning in the end. They put it in before they put the walls in so they can get all the ductwork and stuff in. So he loves them, but he hates the 1500s. He had 1500s and he hated them, but he likes the 2500. And I would not buy a Chrysler, Stellantis, whatever you want to call them product. I would not buy a Ram. James Self says, Scotty, when are you going to spend the millions? Probably never. It's a game to me. I like making it. My kids and grandkids will probably inherit most of it. And my wife's as cheap as me. So we like driving around in old cars. It's a badge of honor. You know, it's a badge of honor driving around in older cars that still look good. You take care of them. Why throw money away on stuff that you don't need to? You know, it's stupid. I'm so cheap. I even sew my paratrooper boots back up. If they get a rip in them, I'll sew them back up with needle and thread and those cool little vampires I have to grab them so they don't slip and sew them through. So I don't think I'll ever spend them. Pycromancer says, advice, I want a fun daily driver which drinks gas. You have fun with a Mustang, you get horrible gas mileage if you drive it hard. You know, you want one that gets good gas mileage. Maybe you want to get a little Mazda Miata. They get good gas mileage and they're fun to drive around in. But, you know, the faster you go, the worse the gas mileage in any car. Even if you got a Toyota Corolla, if you're beating the heck out of it, it's going to get worse gas mileage. But, of course, the faster the car you get, like a big V8 engine or a turbocharged engine, the faster you drive, it drastically get worse gas mileage in those. Where even if you drive the heck out of a Corolla, it's still going to get decent gas mileage. But I mean, maybe a Mazda Miata would be something you'd like. Clean Lyric says, what do you think of Cummins engines? Cummins makes excellent diesel engines. They're excellent engines. There's nothing wrong with their engines. You know, they make giant diesel engines for big giant trucks too, and make all kinds of stuff. And it is a very good company. Jimmy Chu says, Scotty, what do I do about a broken auxiliary plug? I got a 2012 Honda Accord. The tip of my auxiliary cord fell in a hole after I pulled the cord out. I can't get checking it out. Help. Okay. Well, get yourself some needle nose pliers. Long, thin ones, like you used for toy models. Try to get it out. First, disconnect the battery so you don't short anything out. Then start reaching and trying to get it out. But those are cheaply made. You might have to buy another one. If you can't, and it breaks when you get it out, or you can't get it out, you might have to buy another one. They're not all that expensive. You got to take some of the dash apart to get inside to get it all unscrewed and screwed it back in. But when you're working on it, take the negative terminal off the battery first so you don't short anything. Then the needle nose pliers, I've had pretty good luck getting those things apart. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.